as well. So I'm here with my friend.
Hello there.
Where are you from?
I'm from London.
You're from London. London, England. This is your first caravan?
My first caravan. I'm not migrating.
No, I know.
People confuse me for a migrant.
Your first caravan, broadcasting, doing journalistic work?
That's right. Yeah, first caravan. I moved down to Tapachula about a month ago.
Oh, wow.
To cover migration. And the story I can offer is I actually got shut in the migrant detention center for 4 days. I was mistaken for a migrant traveling without my passport.
That is horrible.
It was... as a journalist, it was a favor. So it worked out quite nicely. I got to see things from the perspective of migrants and got to see how their rights are being abused, essentially, in the migrant detention centers. And now we're seeing it again in this caravan.
It's actually a fact that this is a migrant prison. Tapachula has become a migrant prison for...
Absolutely. It's the modern Casablanca. Everyone's stuck. But unfortunately, it's not quite as romantic as the film. So everyone's stuck, everyone's tired and sick of it. And
you guys saw this exactly the same thing in the UK?
When was that?
When the mass migration with Africans moving into the UK, you saw that or not?
Yeah, the UK has managed to keep its hands pretty clean of it because it's the last country along the furthest country from the Middle East. So they've managed to take very, very few migrants compared to countries like Germany. And basically get away with it, not have the same problem. So that's not spoken about enough, I would say. But it's a very anti-immigration government we have.
Anti-immigration. Boris Johnson is very anti-immigration.
Yeah, well, he got elected on that pledge. I don't know what he thinks personally, but it's a Trump phenomena. Basically replicated in Britain very soon after Trump came into power. And Johnson basically ran on the same principles and won on the same principles.
But right now, Biden is horrible. Biden, you know, is horrible. He incentivized that he was going to help, and now he changed all his policies. And he basically lied about the whole, you know, I'm going to help 125,000 per year and all this kind of stuff. What is your opinion on that?
Yeah, and with the coronavirus restrictions that are helping to kick people back out of the country, it's the problem there is the hypocrisy. I mean, if you're going to be anti-migration, then be anti-migration and be honest about it. There's reasons to be anti-migration, I'll say that, especially for people in border communities. But if everyone could speak the truth, we'd get a lot further, a lot faster, and we'd stop getting lost in confusion.
There's a lot of poverty right here in Tapachula. I come here, it's my country, I'm from here, but
right.
I have come here multiple times. With that poverty that is created by this chaotic mass migration, and they don't know how to address it, they don't know how to control it, they don't know how to handle it. And there's infections and there's diseases that they're, because of they're not handling correctly, it has effects, and those are the effects. What is your opinion on that?
Well, in the detention center, I saw that very clearly. A lot of people were ill. People were coughing more and more every day. And really, there wasn't any medical attention. It wasn't accessible. If you go to the doctor, if you manage to get out the door of the prison to get to the doctor, you might get a pill. I don't know what this magic pill did, but that's all they were giving. whatever the ailment, you know. So that was the situation in the migrant detention center. There's I don't know if this will be watched by Mexicans or Americans, but a Mexican strategy to deal with a problem, unfortunately, is to ignore it and defer the responsibility to someone else, probably someone in a higher position.
But it's
we're seeing in Mexico.
But it's so stupid because you have an open border between Guatemala and Mexico. It's open, so for them to
not
travel.
Not according to them.
Yeah, but it's open, but you're clogging people into one particular city.
Yes.
And this city is, they're being stuck and they're not being eligible, they're not moving.
Right.
So what is your take on that?
Yeah, well, probably it's a pressure cooker in Tapachula. Really, this is for people that don't know Mexico, this isn't a big city in Mexico. This isn't a place with much opportunity. It's a fairly poor city. It's not a place that you can get a job. It's not a place that really has enough housing, I would say. The costs of renting a room for migrants are actually quite high relative to other cities in Mexico. So it's not clearly, like, economically we can see it's not the right place. There isn't a lot of sense to it. There isn't enough supply to meet the demand of all these people. So let them go.
That's the only thing. So off topic. Not migration. You're from the UK.
I am.
Liverpool, Manchester, or who?
Fulham.
Oh, you're Fulham.
We had one Mexican player in our history, I think. Carlos Salcedo.
Ah, defender.
Yeah, and then he got arrested for some kind of controversy with prostitutes.
To be Mexican. But
and he was really bad. I mean, he stayed for one season, and he was a great failure. No comment on Mexico to make that clear.
You're a really good fellow, like they say over there, and you're a really good guy.